Your own retro arcade game for the most gaming fun ever. 240 included games with clear 16-bit graphics. Full control joystick and buttons, enhanced backlit screen, as well as it operates with 3 AA batteries, which are obviously not included. Okay, so I've taken it out of its box.
Late night lover, you know, the one that swing dick like no other. I know I got a lot of things I need to explain, but baby, you know the name. And love is about pain, so stop the complaints and drop the order of strains. Our sex life's a game, so back me down in the pain.
I can't wait no more. This is the
back past three, and sure days I mean, I got the Bentley Ballet. I'm just outside of Jersey, past the Palisades. I love to see that ass in hoops and shades. Pull out on the bed while I'm yanking your braids. You never thought I'd make you smile while I'm smacking your ass and fucking you all wild.
It's only your sunshine. We've been through worse weather. Stormy night, you wrote a dead guy. Okay, so I hope you can actually see this clearly. It's not always that easy to get some good gaming footage over here. But the main menu, with this horrible little tune playing in the background, is you've got sports games, you've got shooters, you've got puzzle, and you've got arcade. Supposedly 240 games all in all. But you'll quickly realize, as I have, that a lot of these games are actually pretty, very simple little knockoffs of other games. So if you've ever had one of those lovely little Famicom carts with clones on that says it's got 1,000 games in one, you more or less know what you're in for here. Although not as bad as those games. So I think first off, let's go into shooters. So it's a simple matter of going in there. I choose the shooters and I think, yes, why not? Let's have a look at a classic old one. And first one up is a Galaga. So it's a matter of just, and then we're into it. I mean, it actually doesn't sound that bad. Let's see what the controls are like. That's actually not bad at all. It's actually very playable. I mean, the sound effects are there, the movement's there, this little joystick actually plays very nicely. Although, are these 16-bit graphics? They certainly don't look like 16-bit graphics to me. Oh, let me get captured. This to me definitely looks 8-bit. I think they're stretching the... You know, every time I've played... that didn't help. Okay. So, well, that's enough of Galaga. Let's try something else. So it's a matter of hitting that button, it restarts it again. And you can see here, yeah, you got Street here Man, what's a Super Shooter, UFO, Water Fire, some really Ship Defender. Let's see what the hell that is about. Hit the button, in you go, it looks like another little... Okay, here we have a Xevious knockoff. And again, definitely do not look like 16-bit graphics. But again, little joystick plays fine. This definitely is playable. That, I must say, this little menu system seems to work pretty well. Let's try this. Say cross.
stop the claims. Drop the order of restraints.
Sex life's a game, so back me down in the pain.
I can't wait no more.
This is about a quarter past three. And sure days I mean, I got the Bentley ballet.
Never heard of it, never seen this game before.
Past the Palisades. And I love to see that ass in boots and shades. Spread out on the bed while I'm yanking your braids.
Actually,
you never thought I'd make a smile.
Why aren't I dying? Let's try something different. So if we hit that button twice, we should be able to get out of there. And let's see, let's try arcade. And what do we have under arcade? Music composer? Blue Jack? What could Blue Jack be? Oh my word. I have no idea what this is. It almost looks like one of the old Game & Watch. Oh, I see. Okay, you go in your water plants and then they grow. Then I died. Don't know what the hell I was doing. Okay. It almost looks like one of those Game & Watch type games. Shepherd, squirrel, orchard. That's very interesting. Squirrel, orchard. Oh, I see. Okay, so my little man moves there, and I've got to shoot. Oh, okay, and I make the female squirrels on the side. What the heck? I think I'm supposed to feed them. Nuts. Weird. You know, this actually reminds me a lot of playing some of those party games on the Nintendo Wii. Okay, let's give it a go. Yeah. Is this a Donkey Kong ripoff? Moving along the bottom? Shooting a monkey at the top? Oh, and I can jump there. And again, graphics look very 8-bit. Let's go back and let's just try puzzle games. I love my puzzle games. Oh, Sudoku. Oh, actually, do enjoy my Sudoku, so let's have a quick look there. This does not sound. If we have a look at the top block there, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We don't have 7, so I suppose I'll go down here. 7. Okay. So that took that. I don't like this control mechanism for it. But I mean, you could play Sudoku with that. Okay, I suppose I'll play this with a button. So again, it's sort of got this theme in it of lots and lots of little mini games, photo puzzles, stainless, I suppose, color balls. Let's see what that is. Start by
here,
stage
W-I-Z,
one.
You play nothing but the hits. Nothing but the hits. Nothing but the motherfucking hits.
No idea what I'm doing here. Again, very 8-bit-ish. But let's just try a quick sports game. And there we got VR tennis. Penalty shootout. Football training. What else we got here? Darts. Let's try Super
Buggy.
Let's just try one. I mean, even listen to that sound, that even sounds like from the 8-bit era. And I'm winding up, and I'm winding up, and I don't know what I'm doing. So there's the power there.
I like that.
Oh, okay, it's a bit of a... and I fell on my face. So, I mean, what are my thoughts here? For what you get, and for what the price that you pay, I suppose it's not too bad. But it is plastic. It is cheaply made. The controls are, they're alright. Too bad. But then again, these games are, I think even one or two, I actually quite enjoyed that Galaga. I suppose that's why they actually put that first. It's not that bad. But I mean, the rest of these games are all lots and lots of sort of little mini games. Let's see there. Troopers. I mean, look at that. That is as 8-bit as you get. Okay. So these are definitely just little rip-offs of all those classic 8-bit games. And that tune, I wish there was a way to switch the tune off. It drives me insane. The only real game that I would have enjoyed out this whole lot would have been Galaga. So guys, overall, you know what you're getting when you buy one of these little knockoffs. I think these games are definitely 8-bit and mostly just little mini games. I suppose there's probably 10 good games amongst the whole 240, which is why it reminds me so much of those Famicom cards, you know, 1001 games. And they're also similar, all little bits and pieces. But overall, not too bad. Sound is alright, control methods are alright for most of the games. So if you ever come across one, give it a go. It's actually not that bad. I like the shape of it. And yeah, so that is the Arcade Machine Micro from iPlay. Cheers, guys. I hope you enjoyed that.